You're muted, sir. You're muted.
Good morning, DNA, and a warm welcome to each and one of you to this interesting meeting. I think this is the largest directors and ambassadors meeting we have. So give a round of applause and welcome everyone for our monthly DNA meeting. And as usual in every DNA meeting, we start with the leadership education. And here I have a very interesting story to tell each and one of you. I'm sure you all will love this particular story because this story will connect you very deeply with your family, with your organization, with the chapter you're managing in every area of your life. So I'm going to tell you a very short story and then I'm going to ask any three of you guys, what is your perspective? And I will also share with you three perspectives from this interesting book I just got to read. An amazing book by Manoj Vasudevan called The Mousetrap Way, the leadership using mousetrap way. So this is how the whole story goes. Once upon a time, okay, there was a very poor farmer who was living in a farm with his wife. But, you know, their farm, you know, they were a little annoyed because there was a family of mice who was living in the farm and eating all the cheese, okay. So one day what happened, the mouse actually came out and looked through the hole and they saw one gift box and the mouse started thinking, okay, it should be cheese or chocolates or maybe in the night I will go and rob this. But what happened is when the gift was opened, it was actually a mouse trap. He wanted to gift to his wife because she was very much annoyed on this mouse and too many mice in the farm. And you know what happened? This mouse really got panicked, and because it's a mouse trap, right? So immediately he went out and went to the farm. And in the farm, the mouse saw a hen, a pig, and a cow. And first he ran to the mouse, to the hen, and said, "You know what? Hey, you know that this farmer has brought a mouse trap. What we will do? What will we do?" And the hen looked at the rat and said, "That hey, that's none of my concern, man. Why are you asking me?" So the mouse immediately looked at the goat over there or the pig over there, and immediately went to the pig and said, "You know what? Hey, the farmer has a mouse trap. What will we do?" Okay. So the pig looked at him and said, "What? I'm too big to be caught in this mouse trap and all. It doesn't bother me, right?" The mouse immediately ran to the cow, and the cow looked at him and said, "Ooh!" It moved him and said that, "You know what? I can actually smash the mouse trap with my one leg itself, so it's none of my problem, my dear friend. Get lost." The mouse went back dejected, and that night a trap was set with a yummy piece of cheese, and everyone went to sleep. The morning, there was a sudden loud thud in the mouse trap, and on hearing that, the wife, she jumped and said, "Hey!" With a lot of excitement, she decided, "Wow, the mouse is being caught," and she ran to that particular mouse trap. But what happened in the night, that there was a snake passing by, and the tail of the snake got caught in the mouse trap. And the snake was, really stuck in that. And the minute when the wife went and took that mousetrap, the vicious snake bit the farmer's wife. And what happened? The farmer's wife fell seriously ill. She ended up with fever. And the doctor said, "I think she needs nutritious food." So since the doctor advised nutritious food, the farmer actually slaughtered the chicken and created an amazing chicken soup for his ailing wife. But still, she was not getting better. So a lot of friends and relatives came and visited the farmer's wife to comfort her and wish her. So the farmer had to feed them. So he even slaughtered the pig to feed the many visitors who came upon. But still, after many days, the wife could not get herself healed. And she actually passed away. And when she passed away for the funeral, more people actually came for the funeral, and the farmer had to slaughter the cow in order to feed the guest who sympathized with them. So ladies and gentlemen, here is what I want you guys to tell me in the chat box. First three people, okay? How is this story is connected to BNI? Just go ahead and mention the word me in the chat box, and I'm going to ask only the three people to quickly share. Ashok Kumar B, go ahead. 30 seconds, go ahead. How do you think this story is connected to BNI?
This is very similar to a member in the chapter who is getting a lot of business and is not worried about another member who is not getting business. He says, "I'm getting business, so why should I worry?" So this sometimes happens and you fail to help the other member. So one perspective.
Wow, very interesting. Thank you. Shabri, go ahead. I saw you also posting me, followed by Thomas. We stopped there. Go ahead, Shabri.
Yeah, the thing is that if some problem comes to any one of the member or something, if he started ignoring that problem, it's not mine. Finally, it will affect everyone. So it is very important to analyze from the other's perspective, like the giver's gain. You should also be aware of the other's problem and solve it, so that cumulatively we will solve all the problems. A small problem, if it has been taken care of, it we would have saved lot of lives, lot of things. That's what I think.
Wow, thank you, Shabri. Fantastic. Thomas, go ahead. Thomas, what is your perspective? How this story is connected to BNI?
Yeah, so if again, as Shabri said, if a problem is referred by a member or maybe by the LT, always listen to it, always understand it, and make that discussion happen in the MC committee, and ensure that there is a solution being brought in, instead of ignoring it completely and allowing it to snowball into something very big and highly destructive.
Excellent. Thank you, Thomas. Okay, I saw also Anbudan Sharanan. Go ahead, Anbudan Sharanan. 30 seconds.
Sir, what Sabri says, I go with Sabri. Na Sabri solradha solanum nenche. So or problem naka adhaungalukku or problem naka ennude problem illa nu solitte thalli uttu poradoda. So andha problem enna endradhu nammalum vandu analyze pannadha adhu vande or solution kedaikum. So idhu ennude illa ennude problem illa nu solittu poradoda. I go with Sabri, sir. Thank you, sir.
Excellent. Thank you. Let me share with you three perspectives from this book. Okay, this book called Mastering Leadership Mousetrap Way has 18 different strategies, okay? But let me share with you the number one, okay? The first leadership lesson number one is, who owns the problem? See, the mousetrap didn't seem to be a threat for the hen or the pig or the cow. And at the end, actually, it affected all of them and the mouse got spared. So if you look very closely, do we face such situations in our real life also? Probably in our organization, probably in our BNI chapter, there will always be problems and there are a lot of mouse traps are there in our own house itself, in our own organization itself. The question is, who owns these problems? And what a leader does is, a leader looks at a problem as an opportunity to unlock the potential to grow as a leader so that others can admire and follow. Why? Because on the path of leadership, ownership is the first milestone. And we as the leaders of the organization, if we cannot own a problem, the minute you see a small problem, we need to quickly own that problem and find a way and convert the problem into an opportunity. So that's the first leadership lesson from this particular story. Leadership lesson number two. Now, what happened to this rat? The minute the rat saw the mousetrap, he really got panicked. Yes or no? What he could have done differently? He could have done differently various things. Okay. He could have actually communicated in a better way. But as a leader, what happens when you see a problem? If you panic in times of crisis, no one would want to come near you because they see that you are panicked right now and everyone would like to avoid you. And a time of crisis is not a time to panic at all. So whenever you face a crisis in your business, in your chapter or in your life, it is time to stay calm. Because when you communicate in panic, you actually communicate your panic directly. And that takes us to the leadership lesson number three, that one of the biggest quality of successful leaders is how they communicate and influence. And what is happening? This rat, he was running around to all these farmer mills and trying to get some help. Okay. Probably if you would have convinced the animals better and sold the idea that if all of us can get together for everybody's best interest, we could have actually solved, yes or no? So it's very, very critical that there are, as a leader, that there are three ways to communicate at any time. You can actually tell, or you can yell, or you can sell. Yes or no? So that's the reason great leaders always sell their ideas and vision and plan of action. So each one of us are leaders in our organization, for our team. Sometimes telling my work, but that requires repetition again and again and again, and it's going to consume a lot of our time. You can yell out of sheer frustration, but remember that will end up in negative consequences. And the same will happen in your family also. The best outcome is always to sell, because the least resistance will be there. Thereby, you can inspire them so that others can actually follow. So there are more than 18 strategies are there in this book. Okay, because this book says that you are never too small to be big anytime. So if you are ready, if you are someone who is really ready to lead a team or lead an organization, I strongly suggest you guys to go and buy this book called The Mousetrap Way. Have an amazing mastermind discussion with your team members. You can actually do a threadbare analysis. There is also a workbook along with this. You can download the worksheets, write it down. Actually, self-reflection will help you to become a better leader in your life. I hope you all enjoyed this particular edu slot on this particular topic. Okay, so all the very best to each and one of you to ensure that we as leaders get the best out of us and grow ourselves as the best leader. Thank you very much and all the very best to DNA. Bye-bye.